Thank you for clicking on today's video. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe so you can stay tuned whenever we upload, because we upload every Saturday at 12 p.m. Now, on to the question of the week. And the question of the week is, do you have any pets? If so, what animal are they? I have a dog and a little hamster. Muskan has a turtle, and Miranda has a dog as well. Make sure you let us know down in the comments below. Now, onto the intro. Hello and welcome to The Art of Tracing, Season 2. I will first show a speed paint of the drawing, followed by an uncensored style ending where Miranda, Muskan, and I talk about the process of the art and the musical itself, including our favorite songs, least favorite songs, and even memories of seeing or being in the musical. Today's musical is A Chorus Line, our freshman year musical, so we have lots of stories. Now, onto the video. Hi, welcome to The Art of Tracing, Season 2, Episode 5. Today we will be discussing one of our shows. The show that we did freshman year. Thank you. A Chorus Line. I don't have any shirt because it's ripped and I don't want to wear rip it more. But look at Muskan's and Miranda's shirts. Like, here you go, see? Fancy.
School merch, woo.
Fancy. Let's get on with the video. So, let's go to the original. Okay, so this is what I went off by. I didn't just want to do the regular chorus line, because that was just too simple. So I found this, and I thought that looked cute with all the lines. It's a little more modern. So this was the inspiration, right? This is the final product.
Isn't the old one just like a bunch of letters with light bulbs around it?
Yeah, that's why I did this. It's a square. I don't know why it looks like that, but it was very simple. I did this, I think, on a car ride. I feel like I remember doing that.
It's cute though. I would get a tote bag with that on it.
I would too.
It was a lot of just duplicating and transforming. Because it was a lot of just straight lines and just copy and paste, but it was nice, simple, to the point, and I'll show you the time lapse.
You guys hear my dog snoring? I'm sorry if you can.
Slightly.
Oh no! Don't ruin the audio.
Done. It's extremely simple.
Wow. Wait, can you repeat that? I blinked and missed it.
Ready? That this is the longest part, and then bam 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 bam, done.
Beautiful.
And for our music, we're gonna be doing the new Broadway cast from 2006, because that's what our show was based off of. Okay, so for me, my top five would be At the Ballet. I forgot about these songs. Dance 10 Looks 3. I like that one. What I Did for Love, one reprise / finale, that's what, four? And I hope I get it, the opening.
My favorites are also At the Ballet. I actually auditioned with that song, it was very fun. And one reprise, Nothing, I actually really like Nothing.
Nothing.
Do you not remember that one?
The one where, I think the name of the character was Diana, and she's like, oh, I can't, the guy was like, you can't act, and then he died.
With Mr. Carr?
Yeah.
Oh, that one. Oh, the montage.
Whoosh,
okay.
Whoosh, I feel the snow.
Oh.
You remember that?
Sadly, that one was stuck in my head for a while.
How many did I do? Three?
Three.
Three. The other ones that I like are, I guess Dance 10 looks three because it's so stuck in my head, and What I Did for Love. Oh, my dog farted.
Okay, my favorite are At the Ballet, of course. I Hope I Get It. One. That's three. I'm looking through. Probably Music in the Mirror always gets stuck in my head, but only the version we did.
Oh.
I like that version purely because the girl who played Cassie was very good at dancing and stuff. So the originals.
Yeah, I don't like the original. So yeah.
You're so disgusting. Oh my god. Stop.
Did he fart again?
Yeah.
And then probably Dance 10 looks three, because that was really iconic. Let's be real.
It was. I enjoyed that one.
Also, I love how What I Did for Love is the most like famous song from this musical, but we all think At the Ballet is the best because it is.
It is.
Really good.
Especially our version.
Oh.
Nice. This is gonna be this entire video. It's gonna be but our version.
Well, I mean that's the whole point.
Okay.
So I guess let's talk about our show.
Like five memories from it, but that's okay.
Time to unpack our Chorus Line trauma.
Yes. So, for context, our theater was being renovated during this time, so we had to go to a different theater by the same district. Let's just say that theater was not safe. Oh, it was like 40 minutes away as well. Yes.
It wasn't 40 minutes, but it was pretty far away because it was like a district center.
It was 40 minutes.
It was 40 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
For the bus rides being that long.
They were long.
It's because we were talking the whole time, wasn't it?
That is true. I have a few pictures.
If you were with crew on our like a back and forth things, it was long. We had to save like an hour and a half just for travel. Which is why we got home at like 7 or 8 each day.
Oh yeah, I remember that now.
So the first traumatic thing happened before we even went to the new theater. Hates me to say this, so we were making the mirrors out of this
I have a picture thingy.
So so it was this like vinyl thing, and it was supposed to be a mirror, because actual mirrors are really expensive and fragile. So we draped it over a wood frame, and we were stapling it, and the staple machine was just so tough, and my finger was just so sore, and I got a little tiny cut. And it hurts so much.
Staple gun. And that's where the trauma of Steven's staple gun like came from. If you ever heard us mentioning it in previous videos, mainly Renovating Society.
That's why I have a staple gun in Renovating Society.
Little baby.
His hand is so cut up.
This is why they make you sign a waiver before you join tech crew.
It is.
So we can't sue them.
Sending the picture on Snapchat.
Those mirrors came out well too.
Oh, they weren't
those
ours.
Those weren't the ones we made.
We borrowed them from another school because they did a course hanging beforehand.
Yeah, no, I thought that we got those professionally made.
The only reason that our school did Chorus Line, well, there are other reasons, I guess, but the main reason is because we were getting renovated, and the set for a Chorus Line is literally just mirrors and a line on the ground.
Mm-hmm. Literally, that's it. So one of our friends. Lost his phone while we were on the bus ride back, and he left it on. Yeah, he left it in the theater, I think, right?
He left That's it in where... the boys' bathroom of the theater that we were going to every day.
And he used someone else's phone to track his phone on Find My iPhone.
He was
iPhone.
Using, like, Find My iPhone, yeah, on the bus. And we were riding in the bus. Like, all sitting together, hunched over that phone. Like, where is it? Where is it?
And we saw the little dot. And we were like, oh my god, look, it's over Kensington, Maine. Which is one of the streets that we don't live by, but that we were driving by. And and we realized that we were tracking the phone that we were using. So we weren't tracking anything. We were just looking at our...
We were just looking at...
So somebody, like, yelled out that we were on... Well, no, I think it was one of the teachers that said we're on Kensington and Maine.
We went crazy. We thought that
But
the
like,
phone was
oh.
there.
It was so funny at first because our friend was freaking out. He was like, guys, the dot is moving. The phone's moving. And you're like, what's going
Because our first thought was that somebody stole it, you know?
on?
Which I don't know why we thought someone stole it. That wouldn't make, but we did, and we then figured we were just tracking ourselves. So
And then we thought that he still had it with him, and so didn't he like go through all of his stuff and he still couldn't find it?
yeah, he took everything out and
In the
not
middle of the
there,
bus.
in the middle of the bus. And I do remember on the
Amazing.
tech bus, there's
He
no
kept
seatbelts on those
falling.
buses.
Every time there was a turn, we'd all just fall. I think one of our like friends who like he was 2 years older than us, and I knew him from like middle school and all that stuff. And so he literally like flew across the bus and fell on his
Those
Because he
buses
was
run
sitting in the seat in
fast.
front of us. Steven, were you and I sharing seats or were we across from
We
each
were
other? I think
across
we were
because
across
I'm
the
we were
Yeah.
recording each other as we
Yeah.
were
And
dying.
so he was in the seat in front of me. And so when we turned, he literally flew across the aisle and landed on the floor of the seat next
And I also remember one time we were in the bus, right? And it was like the big yellow buses. We were all there, and we were they were I don't know why the bus driver was taking this really weird turn down this teeny, teeny, tiny road, and we like almost got stuck under a bridge because the road went like it
Oh
like
my God.
dipped, and the bridge was like right by the dip, so it was. I thought we were gonna die. I thought we were gonna die.
Did we
It
also
was.
get lost on like one of our rehearsal days? Like the bus that was taking us?
Oh yeah, he
I
did
feel like
take
that
us.
happened.
Then I forgot
Every
the.
I've taken to that specific location has been chaotic, not even just for chorus line.
But back to a chorus line. There's still more
Yes.
trauma.
Oh,
So
there's.
much more trauma.
Okay, before we go
The
on to
catwalk.
that, the catwalk. So the catwalk, I'll snap a picture, I'll just blur out the person, our friend.
Steven, what is a catwalk for the heathens who do not understand theater?
A catwalk is a little tiny thing that's basically right above the ceiling. And that's where you put the lights that shine onto the stage itself. That are like farther away, so they're not right underneath or right above. And this catwalk is, to say the least, a little unsafe.
Little,
There was no
just a little.
railing, there was no net. You could just
The
roll off the
gap was big enough that an entire person could just roll off onto the floor.
I
And
could
the
fit through the
catwalk was
gap.
also like the catwalk was also really high up, like in comparison to other theaters.
It was right underneath the actual like roof of the building. So there was actual nails that were on the roofs. So you put your hand up or jumped, you probably could have gone impaled.
I almost backed into like a rusty
Oh,
nail
I remember
my
that.
first time there. And the ladder to
Tetanus.
get up there was also like weirdly curved. So if you slipped at all, you could fall and like hit your neck on the door frame. So you had to like squeeze in there.
And then,
Otherwise you'd die.
and then a lot of people got hit on the head, in the head, because it was also really, really, you were like all the way down here, you were like, ugh. So Miss Khan was lucky because she was short, so she could just walk. But us, average slash tall people, we had to crouch the whole time, or we were on our knees. It was terrifying. So sadly, we have way too much footage, so a lot of it did have to get cut due to time constraints with the video. But soon, very, very soon, you will be getting Uncensored, the reboot. It'll be premiering March 27th, and you'll be able to catch up on the rest of the episode there, unedited, unharmed. Thank you, and see you next week. But to end it all, this was the least problem, least dramatic year slash show that we've been in. Well, things just go downhill from there. But that's for another day because we are done with this episode. Join us next episode where we talk about Chicago and our experiences and the drama that went down.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you so much for watching this episode of The Art of Tracing Season 2. I had so much fun doing it. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe, and answer the question of the week down below. Make sure to check out all the social medias, and all the links for that are in the description down below. Bye!